CERN's scientific environment very much relies on a culture of sharing and collaborating. And we wanted to continue on this culture, but ensure that there was, let's say, a solid legal framework under which to do it.
So open hardware is hardware whose design is made available for everybody to study, modify, republish those modifications, but also to make hardware out of those designs and to commercialize the hardware. So that's open hardware, and the CERN open hardware license establishes the conditions for the sharing of those open source hardware designs.
So open hardware licensing and CERN open hardware license in particular relies on intellectual property rights to put a number of conditions around giving access to a hardware design. Now, it doesn't mean that you cannot also have intellectual property rights living next to them, such as patent, for instance. You can always patent an invention, a technology, and license it, whether it's on proprietary terms, on bilateral terms, or you can also decide to license it under open hardware principles. If you want to license one of your hardware designs under open source conditions and under the CERN open hardware license more specifically, there is only one thing that you need to do, is make sure that your design basically has all the information that allows somebody to reproduce it. And then you simply say, this hardware design is licensed under the CERN OHL, and then you put which variant of the CERN OHL you're licensing it under, and you put it out there, you make it available. When you get a design which is licensed under an open hardware license, you can use it, but you need to respect the conditions that are defined in there. And one of the conditions, for instance, is that if you make a modification to the design, which is, you know, what open hardware wants you to, and encourages you to do as well, you just need to make sure that if you distribute it, you distribute it so that other people can also make modifications. So you need to provide the source, meaning the blueprint of that design, so that other people can also use it and use not only the original, but also your improvements to that design.
For example, if you're in the global south and you want access, you're a researcher in the life sciences and you want access to microscopes to do, for example, research on malaria, and you want to be able to modify, to tweak the functioning of that microscope, you want to be able to repair it easily, to have it repaired locally without relying on external sources and without establishing a vendor lock-in situation, it could be very useful to have the designs so that you can have all these freedoms granted by the license. Sometimes this foundation is huge in terms of intellectual property injected in it and knowledge and experience. It's very easy to add a bit of value on top of it, either open source or proprietary, and then have a very nice final product. So what you do by open sourcing is lifting the floor for everybody. You are offering everybody technology that they can use to build upon.